Good morning and welcome to you all to this service of morning prayer on Monday the 21st of December as we draw ever closer to the end of our Advent season and look forward to our celebrations this Christmas time when we remember Jesus being born in our world and as we continue to look for his second coming as he promised. O Lord, open our lips and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Reveal among us the light of your presence, that we may behold your power and glory. Blessed are you, Sovereign God of all, to you be praise and glory for ever. In your tender compassion, the dawn from on high is breaking upon us to dispel the lingering shadows of night. As we look for your coming among us this day, open our eyes to behold your presence and strengthen our hands to do your will, that the world may rejoice and give you praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God for ever. A song of the King's glory. The earth is the Lord's and all that fills it, the compass of the world and all who dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the seas and set it firm upon the rivers of the deep. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? Who can rise up in his holy place? Those who have clean hands and a pure heart, who have not lifted up their soul to an idol, nor sworn an oath to a lie. They shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a just reward from the God of their salvation. Such is the company of those who seek him, of those who seek your face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O gates, be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord who is mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The night has passed and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and for ever. Amen. Our psalm appointed for this morning is Psalm 121. The Lord shall keep you from all evil. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not suffer your foot to stumble. He who watches over you will not sleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, neither the moon by night. The Lord shall keep you from all evil. It is he who shall keep your soul. The Lord shall keep watch over your going out and your coming in, from this time forth for evermore. The Lord shall keep you from all evil. Lord, ever watchful and faithful, we look to you to be our defence, and we lift our hearts to know your help, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Our first reading, we continue to hear from the book of Isaiah, chapter 52, this morning reading verses 13 to 50 to chapter 53 to the end. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which had not been told them they shall see, and that which they had not heard they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Led like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked, and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong. Because he poured out himself to death, and was numbered with the transgressors, yet he bore the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors. Here ends our first reading. Song of the Wilderness. Lift up your voice with strength, O herald of good tidings. The wilderness and the dry land shall rejoice. The desert shall blossom and burst into song. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weary hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to the anxious, be strong, fear not. Your God is coming with judgment to save you. Then shall the eyes of the blind be opened and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then shall the lame leap like a hart, and the tongue of the dumb sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The ransomed of the Lord shall return with singing, with everlasting joy upon their heads. Joy and gladness shall be theirs, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Lift up your voice with strength, O herald of good tidings. Our second reading is taken from the second letter of Peter, chapter 1, verses 1 to 15. Simeon Peter, a servant and apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who have received a faith as precious as ours through the righteousness of God, of our God and Saviour Jesus Christ, may grace and peace be yours in abundance in the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. His divine power has given us everything needed for life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. Thus he has given us, through these things, his precious and very great promises, so that through them you may escape from the corruption that is in the world because of lust, and may become participants in the divine nature. For this very reason, You must make every effort to support your faith with goodness, and goodness with knowledge, and knowledge with self-control, and self-control with endurance, and endurance with godliness, and godliness with mutual affection, and mutual affection with love. For if these things are yours, and are increasing among you, they keep you from being ineffective and unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. For anyone who lacks these things is short-sighted and blind, and is forgetful of the cleansing of past sins. Therefore, brothers and sisters, be all the more eager to confirm your call and election, for if you do this, you will never stumble. For in this way, entry into the eternal kingdom of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ will be richly provided for you. Therefore, I intend to keep on reminding you of these things, though you know them already and are established in the truth that has come to you. I think it right, as long as I am in this body, to refresh your memory, since I know that my death will come soon, as indeed our Lord Jesus Christ has made clear to me, and I will make every effort so that after my departure you may be able at any time to recall these things. Here ends our second reading. Then Benedictus. Like the sun in the morning sky, the Saviour of the world will dawn. Like rain upon the meadows, the Christ will come down upon us. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old, to save us from our enemies from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. A new child shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Like the sun in the morning sky, the Saviour of the world will dawn. Like rain upon the meadows, the Christ will come down upon us. So let us pray. O morning star, splendour of light eternal and sun of righteousness, come and enlighten those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death. Lord, as we have journeyed with you through this season of Advent, we thank you for the times that your light has shone upon us, upon our lives, and upon the midst of the darkness that may have been felt. We pray, Lord, for the signs and wonders that we may have glimpsed of your coming kingdom and of your kingdom in the here and now. As we prepare to celebrate the birth of your Son this week, so we thank you that you are always with us, surrounding us with your love, guiding our footsteps, and knowing that you dwell here with us. So we pray for our world today. So we pray, Lord, for all the troubled areas of our world. We pray for those places which are struggling due to this global pandemic, for those places struggling due to warfare and conflict. We pray for those who are hungry and thirsty and lack the basic necessities of life that we can so easily take for granted. We pray for our own land, for this new strain of coronavirus, which is causing so many cases. Lord, we pray for a continuation of the rollout of the vaccination programme, so that we may defeat this virus, that it would come to an end, not only here but across our world, and that people would be able to return to normal life, being able to travel, visit family and friends when we like, to be able to do the things we enjoy doing, to have social interaction with other people. We give you thanks, Lord, for the wisdom that you have granted to so many who've worked on these vaccinations. We pray today for our government and for the leaders of all nations as they face difficult and tough decisions. We pray that they balance the economy with people's health. And we pray, Lord, that the resources would be found that are needed at this time. From our parish prayer intention today, we pray for those who doubt, for those who find faith difficult and who have questions, that you would listen to them, Lord, and provide people to give them answers, help and guidance. We pray for those who are seeking you today, Lord, for those who feel drawn ever closer to learning more about you, that you would reveal yourself through scripture, through other people and through our prayers. From our diocesan prayer intentions, we pray for the economy of our nation and communities, for the Chancellor of the Exchequer and his team. We pray for those whose businesses are in decline, those grappling with new ways of working, and those who have lost or fear losing their livelihoods due to this pandemic. Lord, there is so much uncertainty for people in terms of jobs, general life, things that we will be doing. We pray for those who will be working today, for those key workers who go out to work and those who will be working from home. We pray for those who have had to retrain, for those who are concerned about losing all that they have. We pray for those who continue to be furloughed and for those who have lost their employment already. We pray for those who have finished for their Christmas holidays, for our young people who will be enjoying this time at home, for those who are in need of that rest and relaxation. We pray especially today for our health service. We pray that as we hear the news of increased numbers of cases and hospital admissions, so our hospitals would not be overwhelmed at this time. The resources in people and equipment would be found to care for everybody who needs it. We pray for those who find themselves in hospital and for those who care for them, those who are on the front line and those who are supportive behind the scenes. We pray for those who work in the hospices and the care that they give to those who are coming to the end of their life. We pray for our care homes and sheltered accommodation, for visits that may be able to take place this week. We pray for those who work out in the community, for carers, health workers, for district nurses, and all those who provide help for people in their own homes. We pray for our GP surgeries, health centres and pharmacies, and for all who work across the many areas of the medical profession today, bringing that healing to those who are unwell. And so, Lord, we ask for that healing touch to be upon those we name before you, those we carry in our hearts, those who've asked us to pray for them. And we pray especially for Lisa, David, Morris, Margaret, Mary, Jeff, Alan, Chris, Charlotte, Gillian, John, Jim, Elaine, Susan, Kath and her family, Joyce, Sister Catherine, Christine, Dave, Beryl, Margaret, baby Thomas and his family, Gary, Marion and Brian. Lord, as we bring them to you today, we ask for your healing touch to be on them. And so we pray for those who have died. We pray for those who have died recently, those who have died this past night, and those whose anniversaries occur at this time. We pray for those who mourn, and for those for whom this time is not a happy one. We pray, Lord, that you would surround them with your love, that you would raise them up, wipe away their tears, and point them in the direction of the knowledge of the resurrection and the gift of eternal life, where our loved ones now dwell in glory with you. God, our Redeemer, who prepared the Blessed Virgin Mary to be the mother of your Son, grant that, as she looked for his coming as our Saviour, so we may be ready to greet him when he comes again as our Judge, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Awaiting his coming in glory, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May the Lord, when he comes, find us watching and waiting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you for joining me for this service of morning prayer today. I hope that you have a good day ahead of you, whatever today may be bringing you. We have a service of evening prayer at 5 o'clock if you're able to join us for that. In the meantime, do take care, stay safe, look after yourselves, and you remain, as always, in my prayers.